Praise be the name of Jesus. Dear friends, today we reflect on the kingdom of heaven that grows like a mustard tree and spreads like yeast. The Kenyan runner Abel Mutai was leading the cross-country race at an event in December 2012. Towards the end, he mistakenly thought he had crossed the finish line. In fact, he was still about 32 feet or 10 meters before the actual finish line. The Spanish runner Ivan Fernandez Anaya, who was poised to capture the second place, had the opportunity to grab the gold, but he didn't do it. Instead, Fernandez came close to Mutai and guided him to the first place, gesturing to his fellow runner and rival to keep going. Later, when he was asked, he replied, "I did not deserve the win." Fernandez chose honesty over victory. The videos of his finish went viral and the world acknowledged his act of honesty. He captured the hearts of millions more people than the winner himself. The three parables of the kingdom, the parable of the weeds, the parable of the mustard seed, and the parable of the yeast, teach us a very important lesson. In this world where there is both evil and good, goodness spreads contagiously and grows like a mustard tree. The values of the kingdom has its lasting impacts on everyone around, making the lives of all sweet and beautiful. In the Gospel of Matthew chapter 13 verses 24 we read, Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is compared to a man who sowed good seed." In the same chapter verses 31, 32 and 33 we read, "The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it is the biggest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and shelter in its branches." The kingdom of heaven is like the yeast a woman took and mixed it with 3 measures of flour till it was leavened through. The three parables describe the different aspects of the kingdom of heaven. The parable of the weeds tell us about the twofold reality of the kingdom of heaven. The beginnings of the kingdom of heaven can be found here on earth, but the fruition is in heaven in the final judgment. Only in God we have the final judgment and reward of the kingdom. The parable of the mustard seed tells us that the kingdom of God has simple beginnings, but grows abundantly like a mustard tree. The parable of the yeast also indicates the powerful influence of the values of the kingdom. During the French Revolution, there were many new religions taking shape. They were trying their best to get many followers. One of the founders of one such religion shouted out his frustration in not being able to gather followers. He said, "How can I get more followers for my religion?" Someone advised him, "You get yourself crucified and then rise on the third day, and you will get more followers." In the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verses 41, we see the impact of Jesus' resurrection and the coming of the Holy Spirit after St. Peter's speech. We read, "And the same day there were added to them about 3,000 souls." In 1999, on the threshold of the new millennium, Americans voted Mother Teresa as the most admired person for the century. According to CNN, she was more admired than Martin Luther King Jr., John F. Kennedy, Albert Einstein, and Helen Keller. What made her special? She was the East, the angel of mercy who spread kindness around the world through her care for the sick, homeless and helpless, a beautiful image of God's kingdom. So dear friends, these parables are an invitation to live according to the values of the gospel. They are words of caution as well as words of consolation. The values of the kingdom will always be contagious. They will grow like a mustard seed and spread like yeast. But there will be always challenges from the evil one. But the just and the upright who live according to the values of the kingdom will be justly rewarded. In the book of Wisdom, chapter 12, verses 18, we read, "You have taught your people that the upright must be kindly to his fellows." Psalm 86, verses 15, we read, "Our Lord is God of tenderness and mercy, slow to anger, rich in faithful love and loyalty." In Romans chapter 8, verse 27, we read, "The prayers that the Spirit makes for God's holy people are always in accordance with the mind of God." The Lord is always with us when we live according to His will. May we be proclaimers of the kingdom of heaven through our way of life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.